Good morning. A warm welcome to all of you, our parishioners and friends, and to those who are joining us virtually today. Please make sure to take a bulletin home with you, or you may find it on our parish website, so that you may know what is happening here at St. Mary Parish. Don't forget to return your demands of raffle tickets. Tickets are $50 each for a chance to win the first prize of $5,000, second prize of $2,500, and third prize of $1,000. Additional tickets are available at the Parish Office Center. Winners will be drawn on May 14th at the Peach Dance event. Please help us reach our goal. April is Child Abuse Prevention Month. Today is Blue Sunday, a day of prayer for the victims of child abuse and for those who rescue them. Please see the prayer in this week's bulletin. This Monday is Blue Monday, and all are encouraged to wear the color blue to show the importance of all of us working together to prevent child abuse. Attention, all golfers. You are invited to join us for the St. Mary Annual Golf Outing on Monday, June 13th at Brookside Country Club in Pottstown. There will be prizes for best scores and other skill challenges. Cost is $150 per golfer and includes cart and greens fees, lunch, dinner, and beverages and snacks on course. If you don't golf, you can still join us for dinner. See the parish website for more information or to register. Don't miss out on this fun parish community event. Our Perpetual Adoration Ministry is looking for additional scheduled adorers, especially for our night hours, which are from midnight to 6 a.m. There are currently 5 open hours in that time frame alone that need to be filled. For a complete list of open hours, see this week's bulletin. Please consider filling one of these hours. Your time with the Lord will be returned with abundant graces. Next weekend, our parish will celebrate the sacrament of First Holy Communion. There is an assortment of items available for First Communion gifts in the ERC, which is located in the back of church on the Blessed Mother's side. We invite you to see what we have to offer. Next Sunday, May 1st, begins our annual Spring Marian Novena, this year under the title of Our Lady of Perpetual Help. Please see the feature page in this weekend's bulletin for the novena schedule and more information on this beautiful parish devotion. Mother's Day Mass remembrance cards are now available, either in the ERC after weekend masses or at the Parish Office Center Monday through Friday from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Requested donation is $5 each. All names will be placed on the altar on Mother's Day weekend. Join us today at 3 p.m. for a special Divine Mercy Holy Hour here at St. Mary Church. The Blessed Sacrament will be experienced as we listen to the Word of God, hear an excerpt from St. Faustina's diary, sing the Divine Mercy Chaplet, pray the Litany of Divine Mercy in front of the Blessed Sacrament, and conclude with benediction. Relics of St. Faustina and Pope St. John Paul II will be available for veneration. At this time, let us bow our heads in prayer to Our Lady of Guadalupe, on behalf of our country and our world, for a complete end to the coronavirus pandemic. Holy Virgin of Guadalupe, Queen of the Angels and Mother of the Americas, we fly to you today as your beloved children. We ask you to intercede for us with your Son, as you did at the wedding in Cana. Pray for us, loving Mother, and aim for our nation and world, and for all our families and loved ones, the protection of your holy angels, that we may be spared the worst of this illness. For those already afflicted, we ask you to obtain the grace of healing and deliverance. Hear the cries of those who are vulnerable and fearful. Wipe away their tears and help them to trust. In this time of trial and testing, teach all of us in the church to love one another and to be patient and kind. Help us to bring the peace of Jesus to our land and to our hearts. We come to you with confidence, knowing that you truly are our compassionate Mother, helpless sick and cause of our joy. Today is the second Sunday in Easter, Divine Mercy Sunday. This Mass is being offered for Elizabeth Viscusi, requested by Mr. and Mrs. Nicholas Viscusi. Our celebrant is Father Bellapidi, assisted by Deacon Don Nichols. Our entrance hymn is number 303, Breaking Bread. Gather us in, number 303.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Many signs and wonders were done. They were all together in Solomon's portico. None of the others dared to join them, but the people esteemed them. Yet more than ever, believers in the Lord, great numbers of men and women were added to them. Thus, they even carried the sick out into the streets and laid them on cots and mats, so that when Peter came by, at least his shadow might fall on one or another of them. A large number of people from the towns in the vicinity of Jerusalem also gathered, bringing the sick and those disturbed by unclean spirits, and they were all cured. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger into the nail marks, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." Now a week later, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands. Bring your hand and put it into my side. And do not be unbelieving, but believe." Thomas answered and said to him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book. But these are written that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through this belief you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Happy Easter, everybody.
Happy Easter.
How wonderful that we are here on this second Sunday of Easter, this last day of the octave of Easter. Father, earlier you kind of got confused as to what day of the week it was. It's understandable this week because it's Easter Sunday every day. In our liturgy of the hours, we're going to psalmities before morning and evening prayer. We do the same one every day. So I can understand you. And also, it's only been recently that this has also been named the Feast of Divine Mercy by St. John Paul II. And I've always felt that this gospel is so appropriate for this final day of the octave, because we hear part of it is on Easter Sunday itself, and the rest is 8 days later, today, on this feast. So it's a good bridge. It just encapsulates the whole Easter octave, in my opinion. But most especially even for the fact that it is also the Feast of Divine Mercy. The church didn't change the reading when they changed this to the feast. It fits very, very appropriately. And of course, we see that this gospel reading just drips with mercy. And it begins with Jesus coming to his apostles who are locked away in the upper room where the Last Supper was. And it says, for fear of the Jews, they feared their life. And Jesus comes and stands among them. And the first thing he says is, peace be with you. Great way of showing mercy. And later, he says he breathed on them and said, receive the Holy Spirit, whose sins you forgive are forgiven them. He's given them the power to forgive sins, which only God can do. That beautiful sacrament that we have of reconciliation. Now, also in the beautiful image that St. Faustina was told to paint of Jesus, the divine mercy, with the rays coming out of red and blue, just like these two altar servers here. We have, you're sitting on the right side at this mass. And the blue, of course, meaning showing the waters of baptism, where all of our sins are washed away. It's beautiful today that after the new mass, we will actually have a baptism today, a perfect day for an infant to be baptized in this Divine Mercy Sunday. And the fact that, Father, you tell us quite frequently how the sacrament of reconciliation is, in a sense, almost like a second baptism. How close to the confessional is to the baptismal font in our church makes that connection of being able to also be able to have our sins forgiven after we have received the sacrament of baptism. Because all of us truly need that sacrament, that wonderful sacrament of mercy. Of mercy and love. And then the other ray that's coming out, representing the blood, in fact, both of which came forth from the side of Jesus as he hung from the cross and been pierced by the spear, blood and water flowing out, that red signifying the Eucharist. The blood. The body, blood, soul, and divinity of Jesus. And, of course, at this Mass, we will get that opportunity to receive the Lord, just as he was present at those in the upper room on Easter Sunday and the Sunday afterwards. He was present, body, blood, soul, and divinity, so also here at the altar. When Father says those words of consecration, and when he elevates the host and the chalice, a good thing for us as well to repeat those words of Thomas silently to ourselves, my Lord and my God, showing our belief in that true presence of the Eucharist. Now, as followers of Christ, Christ gives us the example that we are to follow. He gives us that example of love and mercy. We, as Easter people, should be reflective of that. We are to do similarly as well as Christ did. First of all, we should, to be an Easter people, we need to be a people of joy. And also to invite others. To invite others to have to get a taste of what we have as well. And I would say most especially since the pandemic, we've had many Catholics who are no longer practicing their faith. kind of got out of that practice, so to speak. So certainly it can be legitimate in terms of understanding the whole thing of the pandemic that we had. But, you know, there's time for us to be able to come back. Come back to be able to actually receive the Lord in the Eucharist. But inviting them first to that sacrament of mercy of confession. Perhaps if you're going to go to confession, which we should all be doing, and one of the things that we do, we should be doing this actually every day, but most especially in preparation for receiving that sacrament, is to examine our consciences. It's a beautiful thing to do at the end of each day. Where have I fallen short? Where have I seen the mercy and love of Jesus in my life? And when we do, if we truly are examining our consciences, we sometimes can step back and say, Lord, how is it that you forgive me? How is it that you have this mercy for me? And then after inviting them, you're going to get the reaction, are you kidding me? I haven't been to church in years. Yes, I know. And that's why I'm inviting you back. To receive that wonderful sacrament of mercy. So that we can receive that other sacrament of mercy in the Eucharist. So perhaps on the way home afterwards inviting them to go to Mass with them. To keep that up. At our parish here, we are actually going to be having an evangelization day next month. That's another wonderful way for us to be able to go out, people, Catholic or not Catholic, to share that Easter joy, to share and to preach the good news, to proclaim the good news of Jesus Christ risen from the dead. Jesus Christ who offers mercy and love to each and every one of us. If we just accept that. That's part of the example. That's a good way for us to follow the example of Christ in showing that mercy. Not being judgmental, but being inviting and welcoming. Let it be contagious. We think it's certainly a bad word with this coronavirus. You know, we know that it's highly contagious. Well, our faith should be even more contagious. If we but live it, if we believe in what we profess, my Lord and my God. All of us from here bring this Easter joy to all those we meet, inviting, explaining the reason for our joy, explaining the reason for the faith that we have, and drawing others to share in that beautiful love and mercy of Jesus. Give thanks to the Lord for his love and mercy endures forever.
Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light.
Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Trusting in the Lord's mercy, let us bring our prayers and petitions before him.
For bishops and priests, may God continue to bless their ministry as they bring the sacraments to all God's people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all nations and peoples, especially our brothers and sisters in Ukraine, may they experience God's merciful love and peace in difficult times of war, violence, and uncertainty. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those affected by abuse in all of its forms, they may find the courage and strength to continue to grow and trust in the love of our Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this faith community, may the Holy Spirit continue to uphold and strengthen us in our lives of discipleship. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us come in faith to the Lord, who graciously hears and answers our prayers, especially for Elizabeth Viscusi, that she finds fulfillment in Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father of mercy and love, we thank you for giving us your only Son. Please hear our prayers, which we ask in the name of Jesus the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Our offertory hymn is number 471, Ricky Red, Eye Has Not Seen, number 471.
Thank you.
and of those you have brought to new birth, and renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to proclaim you, O Lord. But on this day, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising he restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Free from sin and safe from all distress,
as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Thank you. 14 parishes in the Archdiocese of Philadelphia, the Archbishop has approved that the deacon or the priest may announce, please offer to each other the sign of peace. And so that's why we heard that. It's been, I think, vacant for about 2 years now. So I will also be going outside, the priest and the deacon, and from now on at all the masses to greet people and to say mass. It's been a while since we've done that. Just to remind everybody, the sign of peace is just a sign. It could be a physical handshake if you want to, but if you don't want to, it has to be a physical handshake. It could be a nod on the head. Sometimes we do that up here, and, or just a gesture with your hand, but it's an offering of our Lord's peace to each other. And that's what we do that for. It's not our peace. We're sending Jesus' peace to the next person. Peace of the Lord be with you. And that's just what it's supposed to be. So it's begun back at all the masses. The only thing that we're fully back, the only thing that in this particular parish, it's not every parish does, is receiving communion under both forms, that is both species, the precious blood. But as you know, as Catholics, I don't have to tell you this, the Council of Trent made this very clear back in the 1500s, that when you receive the host, you're receiving the body, blood, soul, and divinity of Jesus Christ. Deacon alluded to that in his homily. Absolutely. You're not being cheated out by not having your precious blood. It's all contained within that. How can we have blind without blood, right? We wouldn't be alive. So it's all contained within the host itself, which is a beautiful gift. Today at 3 o'clock, as Sandy mentioned in her announcements before Mass, we'll have the traditional Holy Hour of Mercy, which is kind of nice, isn't it, for Divine Mercy Sunday? So we'll have a Holy Hour at 3 o'clock today, where we'll be having the sung chaplet and an hour before the Blessed Sacrament, and just prayers and excerpts from the diary of St. Faustina. Hope that you can make that Holy Hour with your brothers and sisters in Christ here in our church. And finally, I just want to point out that we're in our spring fundraiser, which is the Bonanza raffle tickets that everyone received in the mail. Thank you for participating in this. We still have a long way to go before all the tickets are sent back to us so that we can give those beautiful prizes away, $5,000 first prize, which is a nice kind of gift if you're going away for summer. And if you're not going away for summer, it's just a nice gift to have. But to participate in that, so we put out extra tickets in the back table. No one's there. You just grab and go. In other words, take as many tickets as you want. And if you want to buy one or sell two, that's wonderful. And then Sandy will receive them back into the office center. Or if you want to just put them in the collection, in another one, just say the nines around, just put them in the collection. We'll also open that as well and receive them. The Beach Bash, which is the finale of the Bonanza Raffle, will be held in the hall on May the 14th after the 4 o'clock Mass. That's where we'll draw all the winners. And we're having a kind of a spring fling. Everybody's invited. Free admission, free food, free entertainment. It's just kind of nice to get together during the spring and just join each other's company and have a good time. Music and entertainment, so it's kind of nice. And there'll be door prizes and 50-50, and there'll be availability of some more Bonanza raffles before we pull the big prize of $5,000. So I hope that you're able to take some more in the back of the church. They're back on that table just for your taking. Just grab and go and see what you can do as far as selling it to other people. Join in the fun of all of this. Thank you very, very much, everybody. Would you kindly stand for the closing prayer? Grant we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless all of you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
Have a nice day, everybody.
You too, Father.
Saint Michael,
your archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil.
May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do God will